yet untrue is the notion that beauty meets goodness. Suffice to say, the demons here is a metaphor for any me, that is, any me. Any thoughts of only me leads to ego. Yet untrue is the notion that beauty means goodness. Suffice to say, the demons here is a metaphor for any me, that is, any me, A-N-Y-M-E. Any thoughts of only me leads to ego. And when ego comes, everything goes away. Everything good goes away. And that is something that should not be tolerated. Why all the fight when the world is full of war and displacement? Because, my dear friends, life is a battlefield where there is a constant struggle between conscience and desire. Whichever wins, leaves you the loser. So be a happy loser with the divine grace. So far we saw Nidra Devi and Mohini who came to the aid of Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu and Devi are perceived as two sides of the same coin. On special days, the Krishna deity in Mannarkudi is dressed as Mohini and known as Gopala Sundari. Then we saw goddess Parvati, not different from mothers who send their beloved children to fight in war even to this day. The demons got more and more powerful and cunning. In Durga, she matched them might for might and defeated the wicked. We are not done yet. Our next story is about two demon brothers, Sumba and Visumba. They had the same boon as Mahishasura, that they be destroyed in the hands of a woman. They thought this made them immortal, for they had not heard of a lady brave or strong enough to confront them in war. They set out disturbing the prayers of the saints and insisted the duo be worshipped instead of the gods. Time came for Devi to come back and kept her promise, and the heavenly beings began invoking her ardently. Parvati saw the plight of the people and their concerns and sincerity of the prayers. From her body, she created Ambika Devi, who was called Kaushiki, because she came out of Parvati's sheath. After creation of the beautiful Kaushiki, what remained of Parvati turned into a black form called Kali. The beautiful Kaushiki and Kali entered the city of Shumba. Their Chanda and Munda, the generals of Shumba, seeing the extraordinary beauty of the Devi, went at once to Shumba and described her beauty. Shumba and Nishumba sent a demon messenger named Sugriva to Devi to make her go to heaven and to accept him as her husband. Devi told him that she will marry the one who defeats her in a war, and told him off. Thus incited to war, the demons sent their soldiers, and when they were defeated, their generals Chanda and Munda fought with the Devi. Devi was called Chamunda after beheading Chanda and Munda. As the battle grew fierce, seven more goddesses, also called Saptakannikas, that emerged from the bodies of seven devatas, joined the battle. From Brahma emerged Brahmani, Vaishnavi from Vishnu, Maheshwari from Shiva, Indrani from Indra, Kaumari from Kartikeya, Varahi from Varaha, and Narasimhi from Narasimha. Lord Shiva, auspicious to all the beings, came there to the battlefield surrounded by these goddesses and thus said to Chandika to quickly destroy all the demons and also let the other goddesses to join them on their side to kill the wicked demons. Chandika sends Lord Shiva as a messenger to Shumba and Nishumba with an ultimatum: go back where they came from or die in the battlefield. Lord Shiva dutifully conveys the message. The goddess blew her conch, heralding the final battle. The brothers sent their trump card, Ratta Bija. He had a unique boon where from every drop of blood that fell on earth, there sprouted a new Ratta Bija clone, still as powerful as the original. So every time he was hurt and bled, there was numerous clones and the battle seemed never ending. Then as per Devi's request, Kali started drinking every drop of blood before it reached the ground. So finally, only the real one was left, and he too was destroyed. All the Devis killed Nishumba and his armies. Finally, only Shumba remained. Outnumbered, Shumba taunted that Devi needed help from others to defeat. Thus enraged, the goddesses merged into one Devi and single-handedly destroyed the world of all evil.
ॐ अग्नवेल पुरोहितै यज्ञस्य देवमृत्युजं होतारं रत्नदातावं आदित्याय च सोमाय मंगलाय बुधाय च गुरुशुक्रह नभ्यश्च राघवे केतवे नमः आदित्याय
अभयम् என்றால் அக்கணமே அருகில் வந்து சகாயம் செய்வேன். அஞ்ச வேண்டாம் தேவர்களே, அஞ்ச வேண்டாம்.
Thank you.
Shiva burned Manmada, or god of love, into ashes. From those ashes rose a demon called Bandasura. After many years of penance, he was given the boon of being able to absorb half the power of his opponents. He made the entire world impotent and ruled from the city called Shonitapura, after which he started troubling the immortal Devas and the sages. The Devas and Rishis performed the havan, and from the havan pit, riding a chariot, emerged Lalita Tirupura Sundari. The Devi assured her devotees that she would put an end to Bandasura. After her manifestation, Lord Brahma approached her and urged her to take a husband. The Devi tossed a flower garland that fell on Shivalingam, designating her divine counterpart, Lord Shiva. Devi departed at once to battle shortly after her wedding. A fierce battle followed. There were clever strategies and counter strategies. Towards the end of the battle, Bandasura tried to exert the power of his boon upon her and was overwhelmed. He regenerated every asura, Raktabija, Madhu, Kaitaba, and others. The goddess' power is infinite in scope, and half of infinity is still infinite. It was too much for Bandasura. Devi laughed and in turn generated Kali, Durga and others and destroyed every demon. Bandasura went down in defeat and death before her, and all his allies and his city were destroyed.
Thank you.
दादा
Thank you.
The highest of all feminine types in India is mother, higher than wife. Wife and children may desert a man, but his mother never. Mother is the same or loves her child perhaps a little more. Mother represents colorless love that knows no barter, love that never dies. Who can have such love? Only mother, not son, nor daughter, nor wife. I am the power that manifests everywhere, says the mother. She who is bringing out this universe and she who is bringing forth the following destruction. No need to say that destruction is only the beginning of creation. The top of a hill is only the beginning of a valley. Bearing Swami Vivekananda's words in mind, let us enjoy the show. We conclude tonight's program with a Tillana in praise of Devi Lalita Parameshwari. Tillana is a final piece of a dance rendition. It is an expression of joy, dynamism and triumph. The scene portrayed is the divine abode of Devi seated on a four-legged cot, the four legs representing Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva and Rudra. She has the young Bala Tripurasundari on her lap. It is only apt to conclude the Devi's glory by singing her praise with a meditative hymn from the Lalita Sahasranama, the text that glorifies the thousand names of the Divine Mother.
Bye. But we are not done yet. It is an incredible, incredible feast to see something like this in Calgary or anywhere in the world. We can't thank our accompanying artists, our teachers, the technical help that we have received, lighting by Melvin and Graham, sound by Al, ushers outside, and soon to the curtains, and all of the other wonderful Montreal University staff who have helped us in organizing this program. I would like to now, in a traditional form of the Sabha, invite our priest, Sri Rajkumar, to felicitate all of our artists. Please do bear with us. He is going to say what we call as Asirvachanam, or blessings to the artists for further growth and prosperity. Please be seated. Those of you who are standing, come and join us. We are not going to take very long time. Thank you. By inviting our musicians, Mahalakshmi Narasimhan, she was our lead vocalist, next we have Archana Vaidheshwaran, a young and upcoming budding talent from Calgary. Born and raised, incredible honor to have them join us here. Then we have Sneha, who is on Natuangam. Without the Natuangam or the cymbals, the dancers cannot keep pace. It is an incredible, incredible talent. Thank you very much for sharing it with us. The accompanying musicians, we have violinist Sri Mukund, Sri Malfi Das, Malfi Das was on rhythm pad. This is kind of unique because traditional Indian dances are predominantly using mridangam. So he has mastered and adapted a Western electronic techno instrument for this particular type of event. Congratulations, Malfi. We look forward to seeing a lot more of you. Finally, no dance will be complete without the percussion of the mridangam. We have Abhi Iyer, who not only did mridangam, he also took the tablas concurrently. An amazing feat. Abhi, Malpi, Mukund and Sneha have all joined us from Edmonton. They have made numerous trips to help us in practices with the students. And the dazzling choreography and immense number of hard work, the effort, well over 250 hours, if I have to put a small estimate of time, I don't know how many hours she spent, Karthika Ganesh. She went to Karthika Ganesh. And all of her students, they have been practicing since November. We started this concert, or the idea came to us sometime in September. By November we had distilled it, and Kartika had identified who are and what part and how who moves. The other amazing thing about it is not only all of these costumes have been brought in from India, you have seen a world record in terms of 12 second costume changes. Never before has it happened in the world. You know, changing from a male character to a female character, you know. We have additional, our asuras, you know, the three gentlemen. Come on up front, we got to see you. Jay, Sundar, Panuswami, please come front. We got to see you. come on to the front. You've got to do the walk, man. You've got to do the walk. This program could not have been so successful without the support of all of you who have come here and spent your evening with us on Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. And Mom is here in the audience. You know, they came from India. So. And we do have our priest here. He's going to actually chant our Asirvachanam now.
श्रियमेवावरुन्धे शीते भाते पुनर्निवेद्याः क्षेमो वै राष्ट्रस्य शीतो भातः क्षेममेवावरुन्धे शतञ्जीव शरदो वर्धमानित्यकमो भवति शतमिति शतञ्जीर्कमाजुरुमरुतयेन मर्धयन्ति शतमेव शतात्मानो भवति शतमनन्तो भवति शतमैश्वर्यं भवति शतमिति शतञ्जीर्कमाजुः आजुर्द अग्ने हविषोजुषानो घृतप्रतीको घृतयो निरेधे घृतं पीत्वा मधुदारुगव्यो पितेम पुत्रमभिरक्षरादिवम् ॐ प्रणो नः प्रप्रणो देवी देवी नः प्रप्रणो देवी नो देवी देवी नो नो देवी सरस्वती सरस्वती देवी नो नो देवी सरस्वती देवी सरस्वती सरस्वती देवी देवी सरस्वती वाजे भिर्वाजे भिस्सरस्वती देवी देवी सरस्वती वाजे भिः सरस्वती वाजे भिर्वाजे भिस्सरस्वती सरस्वती वाजे भिर्वाजनीवती वाजनीवती वाजे भिस्सरस्वती सरस्वती वाजे भिर्वाजनीवती वाजिनी वती वाजिनी वती धीना पवित्र्य वित्री धीना धीना पवित्र्य वत्तवत्री धीना धीना पवित्र्य वतो अवित्र्य वत्तवत्त वित्र्य वतो अवत्तित्य वतो श्रियमेवावरुन्धे शीत भाते पुनर्निवेद्याः क्षेमो वै राष्ट्रस्य शीतो भातः क्षेममेवावरुन्धे शतमानं भवत् शतायुःपुरुषस्येन्द्रिय आयुष्येवेन्द्रिये प्रतिष्ठते मनोभीष्टसिद्धिद्वारा अनन्तकीर्तिप्रतिष्ठायोग्यताफलसिद्धिद्वारा मार्कण्डेयायुष्यावृद्धिद्वारा स्वस्तिमन्त्रार्था सत्याः सफला सन्तु श्रीमन्तो महान्तो निघृण्णन्तो अनयोध्यमानस्य कुमारस्य कुमार्याः सकलविद्यापारङ्गतासिद्धिद्वारा सकलविद्यासिद्धिरस्तु अखण्डैश्वर्याभिवृद्धिरस्तु तथास्तु शतमानं भवति शतायुःपुरुषस्येन्द्रिय आयुष्येवेन्द्रिये प्रतिष्ठति
for Ms. Kartika Ganesh and our wonderful, wonderful students who have spent their every single Saturday and Sunday since November. Last 2 months have been incredible. And it's our torture for some of the students. Some of them have got examinations tomorrow, IB exams nonetheless, and they are here tonight. We do also want to thank Shri Jagtar Singh Ji from the Asian Magazine TV channel who is covering us today. Please put your name to the channel and look up the G's website. And Shri Anagadatta Society has been honored and privileged to support all of our young and upcoming artists here in Calgary and in Alberta. All of this is not possible without continuous support from everybody. We look forward to your continuous support and donations at the temple. To keep the temple running, we have an average cost between $8,000 and $9,000 a month. So we do look forward to continuous regular support from all of us, all of you, so that not only is the temple running, but we also are able to continue such programs for all of us. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Have a safe drive. Thank you very much. Om Shanti Shanti.